My name is Colette Davis, and this is my fire-breathing three-rotor RH7 FC. It was the first car that I had that I was able to express myself in any way that I wanted to, and really what I learned how to build cool builds and cars on. Like, I used this as a learning platform. I messed up a lot. If you look inside of it, you know, this was the very first time that I learned how to paint a car. It was the first time that I learned about wiring a car, and this was my very first drift car that I even decided to build and go into more of the drifting motorsport. So for me, it's very sentimental. It was a lot of firsts, and actually going into this year will be the very first time that I'm completely rebuilding it from the ground up. Now that it's been fully tested, beaten, sent through battle, you know, we know that the powertrain is good, we know what it wants, and most importantly, we know what changes we need to make it even better. Now that we've gone through all the evolution, this car is actually getting a brand new, beautiful chassis that we're going to be building on this year and doing everything right. You know, this car is very, very sentimental to me. I learned things for the first time and did so many things myself, but it's time to move on and do things the professional way from the ground up. So I'm very excited that I found a clean Turbo 2 FC shell and going to move everything into that and debut it end of this year. I actually have a Hot Wheels coming out. It's a diecast of this exact car, but it's going to be its new version that's gonna come out later this year. For me, I really started in racing with go-karts and really transferred into racing cars pretty quickly. You know, I don't come from a family of racing, and going from go-karts to cars was a very big jump. Real fast, I had to learn how to raise money, make a legit program around myself, and learn marketing so that I could do what I loved, which was racing cars. I started out pursuing IndyCar, doing open wheel racing. I did my first pro races on the Mazda Road to Indy, racing USF 2000 race cars. And throughout that journey, you know, multiple years just jumping in and out of a bunch of different open wheel cars. Eventually transitioned into doing a lot of sports car racing, and then debuted on a Red Bull Global Rallycross series in 2015. And that's where I really just was doing this full time and racing and living the dream and absolutely loving it. That's when I started transitioning into drifting. I got this beater of an RH7 FC for $2,500. It was already a Turbo 2 car, and the very first day that I drove home with it, it tried catching on fire, and the wiring harness just already started melting down, and I was like, yep, this is it. This is going to be a very long road, but I knew that I wanted to build more and like I said, have that control into my future in this world that I love so much. So while starting to get into the drifting world with this build, I also had the chance to compete monster trucks. So I was actually the driver of the Wonder Woman Monster Jam truck in 2018. We debuted that truck, and that was a whole nother world. You know, that opportunity kind of came out of nowhere. They asked me to go audition. There is a place called Monster Jam University that they audition hundreds of drivers. And that was a really great experience. You know, I think those vehicles are so wild and so unique. And for me, my favorite thing was just doing the tricks and the stunts in them. You know, when you're doing a handstand or popping a wheelie, you're like 20 feet in the air, figuring out what the bottom of your vehicle is doing, modulating throttle, you know, now that they're flipping them just in small arenas. So it was a lot to learn. But while I was doing the monster trucks, I was also building the drift platform, because I knew that's ultimately where my heart was and where I wanted to go. First competition really was at the LZ Invitational last year. And before that, over the years, it's just been dialing this thing in, figuring it out. You know, I think my journey within the Rotary community and learning has been up and down, left, right, all over the place. And I would say just in the past few years, am I finally like on a good direction? I've experienced a lot. I've experienced what's bad, what's good. And now in this car, things are sorted and we're driving and we're on that next evolution of, okay, we can go to competitions with it. And the very first comp that I did at the LZ Invitational, this thing ripped. It was effortless. It was one of the fastest cars there. I think it was fastest entries. Fastest car that Adam's ever driven as well. And it blew me away. So I think we're so close to having an insane formula and a rocket here that I could definitely see myself wanting to compete in this platform going into next year. Here in the US, you know, thankfully people like Rob are literally just putting it out there what they're doing. You're trying, you're either succeeding or you're failing, and you're putting it out there so people can learn from it. I think we need a lot more of that, especially in the Rotary community. And that's what I try and do with my content. You know, since I got this car, I've been filming everything that works and everything that doesn't work and putting it on YouTube. And I definitely expected a lot of people to hate that when I first started being a female, but then also painting my car pink and putting sparkles everywhere, because I'm just doing what I like and I'm always gonna do that. And a lot of people were supportive, and it surprised me a little bit, but I think just being out there and showing what this engine can do in this platform is great. And I think it's gonna hopefully help build a community up that's been lost within the Rotary world.